Now to the high-profile politician who's sparked controversy by appearing to endorse the Church of Scientology. Robert Doyle came close to being Victorian Premier before becoming Melbourne's Lord Mayor, but his appearance at the opening of the church's new headquarters has caused outrage. Brian Seymour has the inside story.
You're here in an official capacity?
As I've said before, my friend Kate Sobrano asked me to come to the opening and I'm delighted to be here at her invitation.
Robert Doyle should be open with the City of Melbourne and I think all Australians.
My friend Kate Sobrano invited me to be here and I'm pleased to be here because she is my friend and people should take no further imputation than that.
The cult's goons close ranks behind Melbourne's Lord Mayor, Robert Doyle. The Scientologists attending the opening of their new Melbourne headquarters at the weekend were in no doubt why Mayor Doyle was there.
How do you feel about the fact that the Lord Mayor is making a speech and welcoming it to Australia?
Great. Good thing. Good thing.
What is?
Lord Mayor making a speech. I mean, it's good to have people on side saying the right thing about Scientology.
You can just embrace what Scientology's got to offer for the community. And what a bad way to have it, you know, promoted to everybody by the mayor himself.
It's one of Scientology's oldest tricks, using its celebrities, in this case Kate Sobrano, to lure in politicians with flattery and friendship, with the sole purpose of having them publicly endorse the cult at the openings of their new empty buildings. Here is Mayor Doyle with Sobrano, and on the right, Scientology's global leader David Miscavige, who was best mates with Tom Cruise.
He opened the building, he pulled the cord, he gave a speech, he was very much there officially and it was a silly thing to do.
Melbourne Talkback King 3AW's Neil Mitchell says Mayor Doyle's endorsement of a brutal cult is baffling.
I'm astounded as to why he was involved and I wonder what's behind it, whether there's something else there that we just don't know.
Today Mayor Doyle claimed he was unaware of the history of serious allegations of abuse against Scientology. The funny thing is, I called him last Thursday and asked him all about that. He became agitated and hung up on me. So I emailed him a list of questions and links detailing Scientology's history of abuse, including forcing women to have abortions, brainwashing, forced labour, forcing child sex abuse victims to lie to the police, and so on. The church is already using vision of Doyle opening its new cult HQ as proof it's popular in Australia. Today, Victoria's Premier and his Deputy Premier, Peter Ryan, condemned Mayor Doyle's decision to back Scientology.
Because I think there are elements of what it practices which are not in the best interests of people at large, and I don't believe in it and I'm opposed to it.
Kate Sobrano gave at least $100,000 to help the cult build its new supercentre as they hounded their followers to raise $20 million to buy and renovate the former Sisters of Mercy Catholic College. Money Senator Nick Xenophon is keen to track.
You need to ask how much of that $20 million has come off the backs of vulnerable and coerced people.
You just flipped this planet all the way around so that Melbourne now sits on top of the globe.
Insiders have told us Scientology cannot even afford to run the air conditioning in its new centre. Its numbers plummeted as our four-year investigation resulted in a Senate inquiry last year, and new laws are due to be introduced this year.
There should not be a tax-free status available to a church entity which is not in fact a church.
That's Brian Seymour reporting, and Senator Nick Xenophon is trying to set up a meeting between Mayor Doyle and the victims of Scientology. We'll let you know what happens.